Chase perfection, catch excellence. Inherit quality, endorse ethics. Cross the limit, dream beyond. Green Valley Public School, Nellikaparamba, Mukkam, Calicut.
Hello and welcome to a brand new series of lectures by students, right? And today we have Naren. Welcome, Naren. Right. So we are going to discuss about
The Last Leaf by O. Henry.
Right.
It's written by William Sidney Porter. He is better known by his pen name O. Henry. He was an American short story writer. His stories are known for their surprise endings. And he also wrote many poetry and nonfiction. His works include The Ransom of Red Chief, The Duplicity of Hargraves, and The Gift of Maggie.
Yes, Gift of Maggie is one of the prominent works of William Sidney Porter, whose pen name is O. Henry, right? You should be knowing O. Henry. Yes, he is a part of the schools and also colleges. A lot of stories have been published and they are part of the school curriculum and also the college curriculum. Right. So, do you know another name for the pen name, Naren?
Yes, pseudonym.
Yes, very good. Pseudonym is the another name for the pen name, right?
Yes.
Yes. Pseudonym. Right. What do you mean by pseudo?
Pseudo means false and yes. Name means name.
Yes. So we break the name into two halves, right? So pseudo means false. Of course, you should have learned such words in science like yes. Pseudopodia. Yes, false legs, right? Yes. O. Henry is known to be one of the remarkable writers, as you can see. So he belongs to America. He's an American writer, right? He was born in North Carolina, US, and he got an interesting childhood, as you can see. He attended school taught by his aunt, then clerked in his uncle's drugstore, right? Then where he worked on a ranch in a general land office. Okay, he began writing sketches at about the time of his marriage. And the Rolling Stone, he started a humorous weekly, which is the Rolling Stone. When that venture failed, Porter, that is our O. Henry, joined the Houston Post as a reporter, columnist and occasional cartoonist. So he has a lot of feathers in his cap. As you can see, he was a reporter, columnist and also an occasional cartoonist. Right. So he was born in?
He was born in September 11, 1862. In Greensboro, North Carolina, and he died in June 5, 1910 in New York City.
Yes, so he died at a tender age of 47, as you can see. Some of the notable works are given here.
Some works by O. Henry are Whistling Dick's Christmas Stocking, 1899, Cabbages and Kings, 1904, The 4 Million in 1906, The Gift of the Maggie, The Furnished Room, The Last Leaf, Whirligigs in 1910, The Heart of the West, 1907, Sixes and Sevens, 1911.
Right. Of these, as you can see, The Last Leaf, The Gift of the Maggie are quite too popular. Yes. So we go to our PDF, right?
Yes.
So what is the setting here of the story? Naren,
Sue and Jonesy are the main characters, and this story is in autumn season. We know that the trees shed their leaves in this season.
Right.
And other character is Burman. He is a painter.
Yes. So there are mainly three characters here. Two girls, they are friends, right? You will get to know how deep is their friendship, how faithful they were, right? Sue and Jonesy. They are both artists, right? They are two young artists, and there is another Burman who is also a kind of an artist, a painter he is, right? So these are the characters here, and they live in the same flat, right? They shared a small flat. The flat was on the
third story of an old house.
Right.
Jonesy fell very seriously ill in November. She had pneumonia. She would lie in her bed without moving, just gazing out of the window. Sue, her friend, became very worried. She sent for the doctor. Although he came every day, there was no change in Jonesy's condition. One day, the doctor took Sue aside and asked her, "Is anything worrying Jonesy?" "No," replied Sue. "But why do you ask?" The doctor said, "Jonesy, it seems, has made up her mind that she is not going to get well. If she doesn't want to live, medicines will not help her."
Okay, this is an important part of the story. You should underline these words, right? So we see that Jonesy suffers from pneumonia, right? There is a Sue and there is a Jonesy. Please keep these names in mind, right? So these are the main characters. We know that Jonesy has this illness which is called pneumonia. We know that it is a illness that affects the lungs, right? Yes. So she had that breathing issue. So pneumonia was a disease that was spreading rapidly at that point of time that we are describing the story, right? So we see that a lot of people are infected with pneumonia. So Jonesy is also infected and she is suffering from that illness. So the doctor checks with her and she says, the doctor asks Sue, "What's bothering Jonesy?" So, and the doctor also puts that she is not going to get well. If she doesn't want to live, medicines will not help her. So she's the well-being or the health is declining and she won't get well if she doesn't want to, right? So what is that particular effect called, Nari?
I think it's placebo effect.
Very good. Yes, placebo effect exactly is that effect which is being mentioned here, right? So you know anything about that effect?
If we doesn't have the will to live or doesn't have the strong will or determination, the medicines will be not effective on our body.
Okay, if we don't, that's how you say, okay? Oh, she or he doesn't. If we don't have that intention that we will get well or we are recovering, then the medicine that we are having will not have an effect, right? So that is called the placebo effect. It is quite psychological, it's prominent, okay? It plays a main role in those medical technology, right? So even if you have such costly medicines, such expensive dose of medicines, if you don't have a feeling that you will recover, surely you're not going to recover, right? So it all depends on the mind, right? The will, the mind. Yeah.
Sue tried her best to make Jonesy take an interest in things around her. She talked about clothes and fashions, but Jonesy did not respond. Jonesy continued to lie still on her bed. Sue brought her drawing board into Jonesy's room and started painting. To take Jonesy's mind off her illness, she whistled while working.
Okay.
Suddenly,
yes. So we see that Sue is trying to comfort her, right, Naren?
Yes.
You can see that they are all both artists and Jonesy is so ill. So what is Sue doing? She's taking her drawing board, she's sitting with her, she's trying to appease her, she's trying to pacify her weakness, right, her illness, and she's trying to draw a picture. And as you can see, she speaks about clothes and fashions to keep her attention away, right, apart from her illness. That's what's happening here. So deep was their friendship, so understanding they were. Yes.
Suddenly Sue heard Jonesy whisper something. She quickly rushed to the bed and heard Jonesy counting backwards. She was looking out of the window and was saying 12. After some time she whispered 11, then 10, then 9, 8, 7. Sue anxiously looked out of the window. She saw an old ivy creeper climbing halfway up the brick wall opposite their window. In the strong wind outside, the creeper was shedding its leaves.
Right. So we see that she is counting backwards. What is she actually doing? She is looking at an
old ivy creeper.
Old ivy creeper. Usually we have a lot of different kind of creepers in our homes, right? The creepers give a lot of beauty to your homes, right? Right. So she's counting on the number of leaves that is falling from the creeper. You know that in autumn the leaves shed and she's counting the number of leaves. She started with 12 and she's reached somewhere about 7, as you can see, right? Yeah.
What is it, dear? Sue asked. 6, whispered John C. They are falling faster now. 3 days ago, there were almost 100 leaves. There are only 5 left now. It is autumn, said Sue, and the leaves will fall. When the last leaf falls, I will die, said John C. with finality. I have known this for the last 3 days.
Okay. So what's happening? So the leaves are just 6 now. You see that how carefully she was counting. She says that there were 100 leaves just 3 days back and now there are only 6 leaves. So she's so carefully counting that. She's noting that so intently, right? Yeah. And she's associating the leaves with her
life.
Yeah, life. Right. And she says, when the last leaf falls, I will die. Right? With finality, with so much of surety, she says, I have known this for the last 3 days. So she was calculating that. Right? So what does Sue reply? Oh, that's nonsense. What have old ivy leaves to do with your getting well? The doctor is confident that you will get better. That's what John C. says. The ivy leaves has nothing to do with your wellness, right? John C. did not say anything.
Sue went and bought her a bowl of soup. I don't want any soup, said John C.
I'm not hungry.
Now there are only 4 leaves left. I want to see the last one fall before it gets dark. Then I will sleep forever.
Okay. What do you mean by sleep forever?
Die.
Yeah. So she says, I want to see that last leaf also fall. Right? And she will also die as darkness sets in, right? So it was so symbolic. It was getting dark and she was also feeling that her life was getting darker and darker, right?
Sue sat in John C's bed, kissed her and said, you are not going to die. I can't draw the curtain for I need the light. I want to finish the painting and get some money for us. Please, my dear friend, she begged John C. Promise not to look out of the window while I paint.
Okay, so what happens here? John C is trying to interrupt her. She wants to divert her attention. Sue wants to divert her attention. John C's attention, right? So she was so carefully looking at the leaves and she was feeling that she will also die. So what does John C do? She sits beside the window and she says she wants to draw a picture, right? And she also pleads with her not to look out of the window. Yes. So she was so caring, right? And she wanted her friend to utterly live, right? And not die. Yes.
All right, said John C. Finish your painting soon, for I want to see the last leaf fall. I'm tired of waiting. I have to die. So let me go away peacefully like one of those poor, tired leaves. Try to sleep, said Sue. I have to paint an old miner. I will call Birdman up to be my model.
Right. So Sue is persuading means what? Compelling, right? Sue is compelling John C. to sleep. Right? And she will make a painting by that time. But you see that John C. is so very, she's restless. She can't wait, she says. And she just wants to see that last leaf go off. Right? Yeah. So she rushed down. Who rushed down?
Sue rushed down.
Right.
Birdman lived on the ground floor. He was a 60-year-old painter. His lifelong dream was to paint a masterpiece, but that had remained a dream. Sue poured out her worries to Birdman. She told him how John C. was convinced that she would die when the last leaf fell. Is she stupid? Asked Birdman. How can she be so foolish?
She is running a high temperature, complained Sue. She refuses to eat or drink and that worries me a lot. So she is explaining the condition of John C. to Birdman, and Birdman is such a good fellow, as you can see, right? So he's asking what has happened with John C, right? What has that leaf to do with her illness, right? She's running a high temperature, says Sue. She refuses to eat or drink, so she can't get well, right? Once you are ill, you need to take care of your food, right? If you are refusing food, then of course it will be quite difficult to recover. I will come with you and see John C, Birdman said. They tiptoed into the room. Tiptoed means what?
Walked.
Yeah, walked slowly, tiptoed, right? They walked in the tip of their toes so that they don't disturb Jhansi because she was sleeping, right? Jhansi was sleeping. Sue drew the curtains together and they went to the next room. She peeped out through the window. There was only one leaf on the creeper. It was raining heavily and an icy cold wind was blowing. It seemed as though the leaf would fall any minute now. Berman did not say a word. He went back to his room. So Berman inspected the situation, right? He just went upstairs and he studied the situation, right? And he just went down. He didn't speak anything, but just went down. It was an icy cold wind. Icy cold wind was blowing. It was raining heavily and probably the last leaf also would have gone in that situation, right? Of course, it's natural. It will happen. Yes.
Jhansi woke up next morning. In a feeble voice, she asked Sue to draw the curtains. Sue was nervous. She drew back the curtains very reluctantly.
What do you mean by reluctantly?
In an unwilling way.
Right. In an unwilling manner, she drew the curtains. Now that Jhansi is requesting her to draw the curtains, she wanted to see if the last leaf is there or not. Yes, has fallen or not.
Oh, Sue exclaimed. As she looked at the vine creeper, look, there is still one leaf on the creeper. It looks quite green and healthy. In spite of the storm and the fierce winds, it didn't fall.
I heard the wind last night, said Jhansi. I thought it would have fallen. It will surely fall today, then I will die.
You won't die, said Sue energetically. You have to leave for your friends. What would happen to me if you died?
Jhansi smiled weakly and closed her eyes. After every hour or so, she would look out of the window and find the leaf still there. It seemed to be clinging to the creeper. In the evening, there was another storm, but the leaf did not fall. Jhansi lay for a long time looking at the leaf. Then she called out to Sue.
I have been a bad girl. You have looked after me so lovingly and I have not cooperated with you. I have been depressed and gloomy. The last leaf has shown me how weak I have been. I have realized that it is a sin to want to die.
Okay, so what's happening now, Nari?
Now, Jhansi told to Sue that she had been a bad girl because she just didn't cooperate with her. She was looking very carefully and lovingly.
Yeah, so you can see that her idea is shifting from, you know, desperate situation to die, and now she is recovering, she wants to live, right? She shows that boost of energy, her mind diverts, right? And she says she doesn't want to die and she had been so gloomy and depressed and she had been foolish. She accepts or admits the situation, right? Sue hugged Jhansi. So we see that Sue realizes that Jhansi has made up her mind to recover. Yes.
Then she gave her lots of hot soup and a mirror. Jhansi combed her hair and smiled brightly. In the afternoon, the doctor came. After examining his patient, told Sue, Jhansi now has the will to live. I am confident she'll recover soon. Now I must go downstairs and see Berman. He is also suffering from pneumonia. But I am afraid there is no hope for him.
Okay, now the story shifts, right? Jhansi was critically ill. Now what we see is Berman is ill. So you know, you understood what happened overnight. What has happened? Can you guess, Naren?
The leaf had fallen.
Yeah, leaf has of course fallen. Of course it had to fall. So, but as Jhansi could see, outside her window, she saw a leaf clinging to that creeper, right? So strongly. So she made up her mind. Yes. So how did that happen? Okay, let's see in the next part of the story. So this is where you say that O. Henry writes a story with a surprise ending. So let's see what happens next.
The next morning, Sue came and sat on Jhansi's bed. Taking Jhansi's hand in hers, she said, I have something to tell you. Mr. Berman died of pneumonia this morning. He was ill for only 2 days. The first day, the janitor found him on his bed. His clothes and shoes were wet and he was shivering. He had been out in that stormy night.
Okay, so who is a janitor?
Janitor is a person who look after the building.
Okay, right. So he is a person who monitors, right? Who looks after the building. Okay. So the next morning, Sue came and sat on Jonsi's bed. So Jonsi is trying to tell her about Burman's situation, and that Burman, sadly, he died of pneumonia this morning. Okay, that morning he died. He was ill for only 2 days. So he was quite healthy. He was okay, but then he died suddenly, right? Within a two-day span of time, he died. His clothes and shoes were wet, and he was shivering, and he was out there in the stormy night. Okay, why was he out there in the stormy night?
Then they found a ladder and a lantern still light to lie near his bed. There were also some brushes and green and yellow paints on the floor near the ladder. "Chauncey dear," said Sue, "look out of the window. Look at that ivy leaf. Haven't you wondered why it doesn't flutter when the wind blows? That's Burman's masterpiece. He painted it the night the last leaf fell."
Okay, so you see that? What happened? So Burman went down in that stormy night when it was raining heavily. He tried to do what?
Draw that leaf.
Okay, where did he draw? He drew a leaf on the wall, right? The exact place where the last leaf was clinging. He tried to draw a leaf, and that gave the impression to Jonsi that the leaf is so strong, it doesn't want to shed, it doesn't want to die off, right? So she recovered, and then we see that Burman sadly died. He also had illness. We see that he is about 70 years old, right? Yeah, so he's an old man. He had pneumonia and he succumbed. You know this word succumbed? Someone who dies because of any condition, we say succumb to his illnesses. He succumbed to injuries. Sometimes we see fire accidents and the victims, they succumbed to their injuries, right? They succumb. So this is one word you can learn here, I suppose. Okay, so she says, Sue says to Jonsi, "Jonsi dear, just look out of the window. Look at that leaf. That leaf is never going to fall off." Yes, right? It might fade off, but then won't fall off. So he made such a wonderful idea to bring Jonsi back to life. And that's what we see in the story. So the main effect that runs is the placebo effect, as we see, right? He painted it in the night, the last leaf fell, right? So you get the meaning here. Janitor, a person whose job is to look after the building. So we come to the end of the story. I also recall a story that I learnt in my childhood, Nareen. I learnt this the story in class 8 when I was a child, and the name of the story is Princess Who Wanted the Moon, right? And I don't quite remember the writer. Anyway, the princess who wanted the moon, please check that story. And you know what happens in that story? A little princess, she says that she wants the moon. Okay, she looks outside the window. She looks at that beautiful glittering moon and she says she wants the moon. So the king is worried, because how can we get the moon to the princess? Right? You know that in the royal court, you see that the princesses want something, they get it, right? So the king tried to get the little princess the moon, but then he just couldn't, right? You can't get the moon to the princess. But the princess was getting ill. She wanted the moon utterly. So what does the king do? He asks everyone in the court. In the king's court, he asks everyone in the royal court, he says, who can get the moon? All right. So what they say, it's so much of kilometers far away. It's so big, right? You can't bring that moon to the princess. Then that's what they say, right? Finally, one of them, I think it's a court jester or who, I don't remember, but one of them goes to the princess and finds out what she feels about the moon. And he gets to know that when she is just putting her finger out, the moon just fits in her hand. And she says that I want it as a ring. Okay, so that's how the problem is solved. So you have to find out what is the problem or where the problem lies. Here the problem was in that last leaf, and Berman and John C. they took a correct decision at the right moment. In a critical moment, they tried to cling that leaf to the creeper. How they just Berman, she conveyed the situation to Berman, and Berman painted the leaf, and the problem got solved, and John C. came back to life. Right? So it's an interesting story by O. Henry. It's quite commonsensical. You get to see a lot of theme here. You get to see about friendship, right? How loyal you're supposed to be, how true friendship plays a great role in everyone's lives, right? So this is the story. I hope you have enjoyed the story, right? There are some questions which we will be discussing in our class, and this is The Last Leaf by O. Henry. Please learn the story well. It's a very beautiful story, and we shall be discussing a lot more about this in our interaction session. Thank you, Nahreen, for joining in this lecture series, and stay tuned for a lot of such lecture series by our students of Green Valley. Thank you.
Green Valley Public School, Nellikaparamba, Mukkam, Calicut.